If you were to fly in a straight line faster than the speed of light directly toward the edge of the universe, you'd eventually end up back where you started because there is no edge. Take 5 seconds and think about that. Howdy, people who want to have their mind blown. Trace here for DNews. This one was super fun to research. A study came out in Physical Review Letters stating that cosmology was safe. The universe was indeed isotropic. I know, you're relieved. When the ancient Greeks looked up at the sky, they realized the universe could be one of two things: infinite, stretching forever in every direction, or finite, with an edge. When Newton described the law of gravity, he thought about this too and figured it must be infinite, because otherwise all the gravity out there would have collapsed to the universe by now. Then Einstein assumed that the universe was static, creating a cosmological constant to make his math work. But then Edwin Hubble came along. In 1925, Edwin Hubble was looking at galaxies. He was a lawyer by training, but loved cosmology and astronomy. He got time on a telescope and began measuring the Doppler shift of the light coming from galaxies. Doppler shift is why an ambulance or a train sounds different coming at you than after it passes. That frequency shift is measurable, and he found every galaxy that we could see was flying away from us. He realized that space is expanding. He published his findings in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences in 1929, and holy crap! Einstein called his cosmological constant his greatest blunder because of this stuff. Mathematician Georges Lemaître solved Einstein's equations in this expanding universe, and once we realized it was expanding, we could assume it started somewhere, and thus the Big Bang was conceived. This was and is a huge deal, and it's only getting bigger. Expansion pun. Okay, so if that's all true and our universe is expanding and isotropic, what does that even mean? Think of our universe as baking raisin bread. If each of the raisins is a galaxy, as the bread bakes, the dough rises, and the raisin galaxies expand away from each other along with the rise, in all directions at once. If this happens irregularly, then the universe is anisotropic, like the grain of a tree. It's stronger, or it tends to have layers, or striations, where it might expand faster or slower. Isotropic universes, like ours, they don't have those. They're consistent, smooth, homogeneous, symmetrical. Ours is all that. According to astronomer Phil Plait, it's expanding at 74.2 kilometers per second per megaparsec, plus or minus 3.6 kilometers. It's now called the Hubble constant. A galaxy 10 megaparsecs away, Plait wrote for Discover magazine, would be moving away from us at 742 kilometers per second. Basically, every million years, galaxies are 0.007% farther away from each other. Trust me, that's really, really fast. And thanks to dark energy, it's actually getting faster, but that's a whole other story. So I'm sure you're thinking, okay, cool, our isotropic infinite universe is expanding, fantastic. Expanding into what? That's the complicated part. The universe, by definition, is all existing matter and space as a whole. It's everything. If the universe is infinite and homogeneous, then it's not expanding into anything. It's just expanding. Think of it this way. You're an ant standing on a balloon of incredible size. It's so big it seems to be flat from your perspective. As the balloon continues to inflate, it is expanding in every direction. No matter which direction you look, the balloon is getting larger. No matter how fast or how far you'll run, you'll eventually end up back where you started. Like a video game from the 1970s. You go off screen, you just come back on the other side. This is how astronomers look at the universe, but it's not a two-dimensional surface of a balloon. It's a three-dimensional region expanding in a four-dimensional universe in every direction at once. No matter where you go, you'll eventually end up still in the universe and back where you started. This is also why there is no center of the universe. Where would the center of the surface of a balloon be? Knowing the universe is expanding and how fast and that it's isotropic keeps cosmology, Einstein and hundreds of other scientists' theories safe, for now. But as we learn more and measure deeper and deeper into the universe, who knows what we're gonna see. If you wanna know more crazy, complicated science, how about the butterfly effect? It's not what you think it is. Watch this video to find out more. Chaos theory, by definition, deals with the complex systems whose behavior is highly sensitive to slight changes in conditions. It appears to be chaos, but it's actually governed by the same rules as everything else in nature, physics, and the universe. But because there are so many moving parts, it's just impossible for us to comprehend them all. I can't get enough of these awesome science topics. Do you have a science question? Ask us below, or go over to our subreddit r/dnews to find out more. You can also subscribe both there and here. And thanks for watching.